church remembers Saint Monica, mother of Saint Augustine of Hippo, who was born in North Africa to Christian parents in the year 332. She was married to a pagan by the name of Patricius, whom she subsequently converted to the Christian faith. Between them they had three children, the most famous of whom was her eldest child, future Saint Augustine, Bishop of Hippo. Indeed, Augustine described his own conversion to Christian faith to the example and devotion of his mother. Monica's husband died when she was 40. The desire had been to be buried alongside her, but for a variety of practical reasons that was not to be. She died at Ostia in Italy in the year 387 on her way home to North Africa with two of her sons. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive them who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Almighty God, unto whom all hearts be open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of thy Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love thee and worthily magnify thy holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Our Lord Jesus Christ said, "Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is one Lord, and thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, and with all thy soul, and with all thy mind, and with all thy strength. This is the first commandment. And the second is like, namely this: thou shalt love thy neighbour as thyself. There is none other commandment greater than these. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets. Lord, have mercy upon us, and write all these thy laws in our hearts to be finished. Almighty God, whose kingdom is everlasting and power, have mercy upon the whole church, and so rule the heart of thy chosen servant Elizabeth, our queen and governor, that she, knowing whose minister she is, may above all things seek thy honour and glory, and that we and all her subjects, duly considering whose authority she has, may faithfully serve, honour and humbly obey her, in thee and for thee, according to thy blessed word and orders. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who with thee and the Holy Ghost liveth and reigneth, ever one God, world without end. Amen. Silence and prayer. Faithful God, who strengthened Monica, the mother of Saint Augustine, with wisdom, and through her patient endurance, encouraged him to seek after you, give us the will to be persistent in prayer, that those who stray from you may be brought to faith in your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. The epistle is written in the fifth chapter of the first epistle of Paul to Timothy, beginning at the third verse. Honour widows who are really widows. If a widow has children or grandchildren, they should first learn their religious duty to their own family and make some repayments to their parents. For this is pleasing in God's sight. The real widow, left alone, has set her hope on God and continues in supplications and prayers night and day. Here ends the epistle. The Holy Gospel is written in the 7th chapter of the Gospel according to St. Luke, beginning at the 11th verse. Jesus went to a town called Nain, and his disciples and a large crowd went with him. As he approached the town gate, a man who had died was being carried out. He was his mother's only son, and she was a widow. And with her was a large crowd from the town. When the Lord saw her, he had compassion and came forward and said to her, "Do not weep." Then he touched the bier, and the bearers stood still. And he said, "Young man, I say to you, rise." The dead man sat up, and he said, and began to speak, and Jesus gave him to his mother. Fear seized all of them, and they glorified God, saying, "A great prophet has risen among us, and God has looked favorably upon his people." This word about her spread throughout Judea and all the surrounding country. Thanks be to God. I believe in one God, the Father
Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and all things visible and invisible, and in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of his Father before all worlds, God of God, light of light, very God, very God, begotten, not made, being of one substance with the Father, by whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven, and was incarnate by the Holy Ghost of the Virgin Mary, and was made man, and was crucified also, passed under Pontius Pilate, he suffered and was buried, and the third day he rose again according to the Scriptures, and ascended into heaven, and sits upon the right hand of the Father. And he shall come again with glory to judge both the quick and the dead, whose kingdom shall have no end. And I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Lord and giver of life, who proceeded from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son together is worshipped and glorified, who spake by the prophets. And I believe one Catholic and Apostolic Church. I acknowledge one baptism for the remission of the sins, and I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come.
The notices are very much as printed in the newsletter, which is available both here at church in Pinkenport and also online on the website and on the Facebook group as well. I don't think there's anything particular to add to what's already there. May I ask you in the name of God, who is Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. It's often said that the family of a powerful man is a powerful wife. Sometimes, my dear, a powerful man, there's an even more powerful mother. Powerful men historically have often had a great reverence for their mother, and in fact, at the same time, Constantine the Great greatly revered his mother, Saint Helena. Augustine, we are told, greatly revered his mother Monica. He was brought up not so much as Christian, but in an age when people were expected to make their own decision. Monica was determined that her son would learn from her example. One of the things he subsequently said was, "She never led me out of her prayers, that you, O God, might say to the widow's son, 'Young man, I say to you, rise.'" In other words, rise to new life in Christ. That's why the gospel that we heard is traditionally read on Monica's day. A bit like how Mary, in a sense, travelled with her son, was part of Jesus' entourage, so Monica was often part of Augustine's entourage. She pointed her son in the way of Christ, not forcibly, but gently, by example, by prayer and devotion. She stands as a bit like our lady, a loving example of faithfulness. Faithfulness to her family, but of course ultimately faithfulness to God. But she also stands as an example, again like Mary, of pointing away from herself and pointing to God. We too are called, like Martha, to point away from ourselves. We are called to point to God. May Monica stand in our hearts. May Monica remind each one of us that by our prayer and by our faithful lives, we too can bring others to know and love God, as he's uniquely revealed himself in his Son, Jesus Christ. That we too, by our lives and by our prayer, can bring others to new life in Christ. Amen. Let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father which is in heaven. So let us pray for the full state of Christ's Church religion here in heaven. Almighty and ever living God, who by thy holy apostle hast taught us to make prayers and supplication, and to give thanks for all, we humbly beseech thee most merciful to accept our alms and oblations, and to receive these our prayers, which we offer unto thy divine hand, beseeching thee to inspire continually the universal church with the spirit of truth, unity and concord. And grant that all they that do confess thy holy name may agree in the truth of thy holy comfort, and live in unity and godliness. Lord, in thy mercy,
hear our prayer.
We beseech thee also to save and defend all Christian kings, princes and governors, and especially thy servant Elizabeth our Queen, that under her we may be godly and quiet for her. Grant unto her whole council, and to all that are put in authority under her, that they may truly and impartially minister justice, to the punishment of wickedness and vice, and to the maintenance of thy true religion and virtue. Lord, in thy mercy,
hear our prayer.
Give grace, O Heavenly Father, to all bishops and curates, that they may both, by their life and doctrine, set forth thy true and lively work, and rightly and duly administer the thy holy sacrament. Praying for Justin, our Archbishop, all thy people give thy heavenly grace, and especially to this congregation here present, that with meek heart and due reverence they may hear and receive thy holy word, truly serving thee in holiness and righteousness all the days of their life. Lord, in thy mercy,
hear me.
And we most humbly beseech thee of thy goodness, O Lord, to comfort and succour all men who, in this transitory life, are in trouble, sorrow, need, sickness, or any other adversity. Lord, in thy mercy,
hear our prayer.
And we also bless thy holy name, for all thy servants departed this life in thy faith and fear, beseeching thee to give us grace, so to follow their living life, that with them we may be partakers of thy heavenly kingdom. Grant these prayers, O Father, for Jesus Christ's sake, our only mediator and advocate. Amen. He that do truly and earnestly repent of your sins, and are in love and charity with your name, and intend to lead a new life, following the commandments of God, and walking from henceforth in his holy way, draw near with him, and take this holy sacrament to your heart, and make your humble confession to Almighty God, which we hear upon your heart. Almighty God,
Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, maker of all things, judge of all men, we acknowledge and beware of many faults and weakness, which we from time to time most grievously have committed by thought, word, and deed, against thy divine majesty, provoking most justly thy wrath and indignation against us. We do earnestly repent, and our heart is sorrowful in his hearts. Remembrance of them is grievous unto us, the burden of them is intolerable. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father, for the sake of our Lord Jesus Christ's sake, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve thee right, serve peace in newness of life, to the honour and glory of thy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, who of his great mercy hath promised forgiveness of sins to all them that with hearty repentance and true faith turn unto him. Have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and bring you to everlasting life. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Hear what comfortable words our Saviour Christ said unto all that truly turn to him. So God loved the world, that he gave his only begotten Son, to the end that all that believe in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Hear also what St. John said: if any man sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous, and he is the propitiation.
give them up unto the Lord.
Let us give thanks unto our Lord God.
It is meet and right so to do.
It is very meet, right, and our bounden, that we should, at all times and in all places, give thanks unto thee, O Lord, Holy Father, almighty, everlasting God. And now we give thee thanks, that thy glory is revealed in St. Monica and all the saints. In their life they have given us an example of faithfulness to Christ. In their holiness we find encouragement and hope. In our communion with them we share the unity of thy kingdom. Therefore with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify thy glorious name, evermore praising thee, and say,
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of thy glory. Glory be to thee, O Lord Most High.
We do not presume to come to this thy table, O merciful Lord, trusting in our righteousness, but in thy only hold and greatness. We are not worthy so much to gather up the crumbs of life, but thou art the Saviour, whose property is always to happen. Grant us therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of thy dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that our sinful bodies may be made clean by his body, and our souls washed with his most precious blood, and that we may evermore dwell in him, and he in us. Amen. Almighty God, our heavenly Father, who of thy tender mercy didst give thine only Son, Jesus Christ, to suffer death upon the cross for our redemption, who made there, by his one oblation of himself once offered, a full, perfect, and sufficient sacrifice, oblation and satisfaction for the sins of the whole world, and did institute, and in his holy gospel command us to continue, a perpetual memory about his precious death, until his coming again. Hear us, O merciful Father, we most humbly beseech you, and grant that we, receiving these thy creatures of bread and wine, according to thy Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ's holy institution, in remembrance of his death and passion, may be partakers of his most blessed body and blood. Who in the same night that he was betrayed took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you, do this in remembrance of me. Likewise, after supper he took the cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, Drink ye all of it, for this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sin. Do this, as oft as ye shall drink, in remembrance of me.
hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive them that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever.
Almighty and ever-living God, we most heartily thank for that thou dost vouchsafe to feed us, who have duly received these holy mysteries, the spiritual food of the most precious body and blood of thy Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ, and dost assure us thereby of thy favour and goodness towards us, and that we are very members in the corporate, in the mystical body of thy Son, which is the blessed company of all faithful people, and are also heirs through faith of thy everlasting kingdom, by the merits of the most precious death and passion of thy dear Son. We most humbly beseech thee, O Heavenly Father, so to assist us with thy grace, that we may continue in that holy fellowship, and do all such good works which thou hast prepared for us to walk. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, to whom with thee and the Holy Ghost be all honour and glory, world without end. Amen. Glory be to God,
and in earth peace, goodwill towards men. We praise thee, we bless thee, we worship thee, we glorify thee, we give thanks to thee for thy great glory. O Lord God, heavenly King, God the Father Almighty, O Lord, the only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, O Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, that takest away the sins of the world, have mercy upon us. Thou that takest away the sins of the world, have mercy upon us. Thou that takest away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. Thou that sittest at the right hand of God the Father, have mercy upon us. For thou only art holy, thou only art the Lord, thou only, O Christ, with the Holy Ghost, art the time in the glory of God the Father. Amen. God give you peace.